Columbus Blue Jackets hockey on Fox Sports Ohio is brought to you by Nationwide. Nationwide Insurance, the official insurance provider of the Columbus Blue Jackets. By your Central Ohio Toyota dealers. See your Central Ohio Toyota dealers, proud sponsor of Blue Jackets hockey. By Huntington, visit BlueJacketsBanking.com. And by IGS Energy, take control of your natural gas costs. Enroll at IGSEnergy.com. And for the final time this season, we say the Blue Jackets on the road here at the Pepsi Center in Denver, Colorado. Steve Mason, as we mentioned, getting the start, his first in five games. You get a look there at his record. Last time out here against the Avalanche, he stopped 33 shots and recorded a 2-0 shutout victory. At the opposite end, Semyon Varlamov, 11-5-1 in his last 17 starts. A 1.75 goals against average and a 942 save percentage and two shutouts. And, of course, starting netminders brought to us by AT&T. Tom Cowell, Mike Lego are tonight's referees. Pierre Rassico, Mark Weller, the linesman. The alternate third jerseys being worn by the Avalanche. Stastny fails to win the draw. As tonight's telecast, brought to us by Time Warner Cable, is underway. And the Jackets move quickly out of their own zone. And we speak about quick. Well, Todd Richards telling us after the morning skate, he is anticipating that the Avalanche, who've not played since Friday, will come out with a heavy, quick game here in an effort to get the early lead. And as he has said repeatedly here in recent action against, it didn't matter what the opposition would be, all those hockey clubs either fighting for playoff positioning or even attempting to make the playoffs. And of course tonight, no different, with the Avalanche needing two wins and some help along the way to secure a postseason playoff berth. Landeskog down the right wing, moves into position, off the goalpost as Mason waved at it. Landeskog with two goals and an assist in the season series. The Avalanche lead it 2-1. Jackets winning the last meeting it was here at the Pepsi Center back in early March. Wisniewski, a right wing feed, fails to click. He looks for Atkinson there, who tries to dig it free along the wall. He's got some help there from Broussard, but it's O'Reilly who will edge it in with Landeskog in pursuit. Played by Nikitin. Up on that right wing. Touch pass there for Wisniewski from Atkinson. Banked off the boards right in on Varlamov. And it's played quickly up ice by the Avalanche. This is the rookie Tyson Berry, the son of former National Hockey Leaguer Len Berry, jersey number 41, playing his ninth National Hockey League game. Up on the right wing, Ryan Johansson. Johansson trying to move in, hangs onto that puck. Tyson Berry defending below that goal line. Those two, no strangers, both former players in the Western Hockey League. A quick shot there, stopped by Colorado. Puck set up high and out.
Well, a good job by the Jackets right now. They make transition back and up and out of their zone. A poster report, Landeskog coming in on that wing. Right now, the difference of the game is the speed of Colorado.
And we got a fight going here. It's Dorsett. And that is McLeod, who certainly towers over Dorsett. But Dorsett, the gamer, not backing down despite giving up some size and weight.
These guys have had a chance to look at each other before, and again, guy like Dorsett knows all about Cody McLeod. Cody McLeod got that right hand free, but look at the jersey. It is off, it's tie down, and I don't think Dorsett's very happy. I think he felt there was an elbow involved, and they both agree to disagree. Eric Dorsett, this is his 17th major of the year, right now leading the National Hockey League in penalty minutes.
Well, likely they'll go five each for fighting. Don't think there really was an instigator involved. So the penalties come at 2:06 of this opening period. 5-minute fighting majors for the respective Blue Jackets and Avalanche performers. Teams remain at full strength. Darryl Boyce set for the faceoff and wins the draw. It comes back to the point. Prout with a shot off the goalpost. So we got a couple of posts here. That one right off the pipe as it beat Varlamov on that glove side. Prout sends it back in. Played off the wall, takes a wicked bounce. McClement can't clear the zone. Second effort, Jones here on the left wing. Prout steps into him. McClement in pursuit, and it's rimmed around the wall by Aaron Johnson. Gillies knocked down. Puck sent back to center. Moving up, the former Jacket, Jan Hayda, sticked aside by Mason. Hayda follows it up. Hayda, a centering feed, backhanded off the blocker of Mason. Jackets were going to start Mason regardless, but this morning, Alan York suffered a groin injury, it is believed. At least that was what Todd Richards told us, what he thought. It was going to be further examined here tonight prior to the game, but Mason was going to get the start here regardless. A centering feed in front, Landeskog can't play it. Oliver deals it on the right wing, waits up high. Puck set ahead, Landeskog. Back here for O'Reilly, drilled high and wide of the net. Avalanche playing as if they had the power play. There's Mason juggles, but holds on. And again, we get some pushing and shoving here. Landeskog, who was involved last time we were here in a little bit of a fight. And there's no further play. The hits are even, 3-3.
Well, Landeskog likes that that extracurricular stuff. He's got 49 penalty minutes on the year to go along with his 51 points. And you can see Dalton Prout coming in after the fact. And it looked like Landeskog gave Mason a little bit of a stick into the midsection. Let's go ahead and take a look and see if we can see that beforehand. That's the after effect. But Dalton Prout did a nice job of coming in after. Landeskog trying to look for a rebound. The play to the stick into the midsection of the goaltender.
Landeskog was involved in a fight with Johnson the last time we were here. Each picked up 5-minute major penalty. Here's Brassard. A drop feed for R.J. Umberger. Drop back, shot by Wisniewski. And the stop made by Varlamov. And again, we get something going here. R.J. Umberger and Shane O'Brien, they've got to be separated by the officials.
Well, Umberger in his familiar spot down in front of the net. And he took exception to O'Brien and ended up pulling the helmet right over top of his head. The referees come in. Let's go ahead and take a look and see exactly how it does happen, because the Jackets run their offense. Nice pass by Umberger. Wisniewski gets a little bit on it. Good hustle coming back by the forward of the Colorado Avalanche. O'Brien gives him a shot. And then watch the hand of Umberger pulling the helmet right off of O'Brien. And the rest is history.
Well, the Avalanche are finding out that the Jackets have come prepared to play in this hockey game here. We've had a scrum at least on just about every whistle.
That's what the Jackets have been able to do. Their last five hockey games, they're 3-2 with a record, but they've been involved in every game. And that means physically, their skating game is there. They've been able to put up some wins, and they certainly have been respectful against some of the league's best.
Well, we'll wait to see what the penalties are. Will they be major? Doubtful, perhaps double minors for roughing. We're waiting for an official call here. And it appears to be 2-minute roughing minors. So, play continues. 4-on-4 with the coincidental minors. Jack Johnson paired with Wisniewski on the point. Jackets saw a 3-game winning streak snapped in Phoenix. It was not from a lack of effort, though. The Jackets firing 54 shots at Mike Smith, who set a National Hockey League record with 54 saves in regulation. And of course, needless to say, is also a Jackets record here. Varlamov making the initial stop. Brassard gets it back onto Wisniewski. Wisniewski away from Stastny, but it's chipped off the wall and sent back to center.
Still a nice play by Wisniewski. That one extra move, if he lets it go, forces the goaltender to play it. He had a little bit of help around the crease.
Jackets Nash deals right side for Jack Johnson. Johnson circles the net away from Jan Hayda. Hangs out of that puck. Dishes to Nash. Camped in front. Johansson. Here's Nikitin. Johansson off the stick of Varlamov. And out of the zone. Puck carried down that right wing by Steve Downey. On here to Matt Duchene. Back for Downey. Hayda moves in. Fires a shot. Pad save Mason. Up high. Here's Downey. Playing his 20th game since acquired from Tampa. There's a shot that is blocked. Played by Downey as he takes it from Duchene. Looking off the point there was Hayda. He'll dish it back, and it's sent into Colorado territory.
Jan Hayda moving in from his point position. 5 goals on the year. The former Blue Jacket. It's a career tie high. Nice to see Jan Hayda really surviving with his hockey team right
Look
now.
Look at Landeskog walk right in. Mason out of the net to stop the Avalanche. as Landeskog just burst by the Jackets defender on the far side of the ice, and Mason forced to make a big stop on Hunwick.
Well, he ends up making the defenseman Aaron Johnson look like he was standing still, and what a play by Landeskog. And look at the little backhand pass into open space. Hunwick moving in from his left point position, unable to finish.
And we should mention he is the older brother of the Jackets' backup netminder tonight, Sean Hunwick, who's in for Alan York. And a former Michigan product getting an opportunity to watch from the bench again. Up ice, Landeskog, rink wide. Into Jackets territory, chopped towards the net, but sent wide. Jared Bull on for Aaron Johnson. 6 minutes plus gone. Back to neutral ice, Landeskog on for Haida. Banked off the boards, moved ahead by Oliver, and into Jackets territory, Mason out to cut it off. O'Reilly pressures, Jackets the clearing pass. Again, it's Jan Haida stepping up at center and drilling it back in. Puck played far side by O'Byrne on for Haida. Haida sends it to the line. A backhand pass from Mueller. Intercepted. A long clearing pass. And it's Atkinson in a breakaway. Watch it. Shoot. Scores! Cam Atkinson on the breakaway. 1-0 Columbus.
Well, you got a lot to look forward to in the future years with the Blue Jacket uniform number 13, Cam Atkinson. When he has the time and when he has the space, the ability to finish is there. 61 goals his last year at Boston College, but watch the pass by Boyce to free up Atkinson, and then he does the rest. Fakes it towards the backhand, and then brings it back to the forehand. The same move on the game-deciding goal up in Calgary. What a great job right there by number 13. To be able to find the back of the net.
And how about that stretch pass to send Atkinson in the clear. 1-0, the Jackets. With the early lead, down the left wing, through and across the line, Jones edges it off into the corner, Derek Brassard fights off the check, loose puck picked up there by Jack Johnson. Jack Johnson dishes to the near corner. Long shot by Hunwick, deflected wide. Darryl Boyce, who sprung Atkinson free, draws the first assist. Colton Gillies the second, 1-0 Columbus. As we close in on the 8 minute mark of this opening period. Eric Johnson on for Hunwick. Hunwick will backhand off the wall, sending it in deep. Nikitin pressured. Finds Letestu, Prospel, Nash onto Letestu, and dished off into the corner. Letestu in pursuit. Tyson Berry there defending. Haidu with a backhand pass up the left wing boards. Duchesne. Downey wristed wide of the net. Lebda pressured, quickly deals. McKeaton off the wall. Letestu's clearing pass, picked up here by Lebda. Sprints through the neutral zone, edges it ahead here for Prosper. Nash, Letestu. And it's blocked there by Jan Haida. Set back up high. Less than 12 minutes remaining. A wrist shot sails wide of the net. Team's back at full strength after the coincidental minors. The two involved in the major penalties still remain in the penalty box as it's played here by Lebda.
Confidence of the Blue Jackets right now, you can see it in their hockey game. This transition game is there. They get into the offensive zone, begin to run their offense, and they do it with pinpoint passing.
Pressured along the wall. Jackets walk it back into their own zone. Jared Bull steps away from Oliver. Dishes it on the wing. Landeskog comes quickly. There's Oliver. Puck picked up here by O'Reilly. Three Avalanche deep in the zone. Jackets break it up. And moving up ice, Ryan Russell. His pass looking for Jared Bull. Intercepted and sent back to center. Jackets will try again. O'Reilly, Landeskog, Prout gets it for Columbus. On here, and it's Atkinson. A backhand pass sent over the stick of Eric Johnson, former number one overall pick by the St. Louis Blues. Up on that left wing, Oliver looks to the right side. Carried in, Mueller. Mueller fires from a sharp angle, high over the glove of Mason. Avalanche unable to keep it in. Here comes Atkinson, sprung loose again. And it's Boyce who does the damage. Backhand pass, pressure coming. Loose puck scooped up here by the Avalanche. Closing in on the 10-minute mark of this opening period. Mueller. for Eric Johnson. Cut head man and then sent in by McClement. Mason holds up Mueller as the Jackets control, and it's Wisniewski sending it in front of his own net. Broussard, the long stretch pass there for R.J. Umberger. Nash out there with Umberger and Broussard. O'Byrne, Paul Stastny, right wing McGinn, darting to the net. Jones in front, he scores! Jones never stopped and redirected that centering feed behind Mason, and we're tied at one.
Well, the Jackets get caught on a 2-on-1, and it's going to be up to the captain, Rick Nash, to be able to get on his high horse and help out. And you can see right now, Stastny chips it off the boards, and watch 61 trying to catch up. He ends up basically diving for that puck, hopefully just trying to disrupt the play. But Jones, who was having a career year against the Jackets, finds the back of the net to make it a 1-1 game.
Again, it's an outstanding pass, this time by the Avalanche, and it's McGinn who hits the Speedy Jones stick on the ice, and he redirects it by Mason. We're tied at one, and now a long lead pass here. Behind the net, O'Brien is able to touch up ahead of Letestu. McGinn and Stastny draw the assist on the Jones goal. We're tied at one.
Well, Jones again, he's right now waiting for a contract. They are not talking to any of the players until season's end. As an unrestricted free agent, David Jones, the Dartmouth product, well, he's going to have an opportunity to probably go someplace else. Just reading his comments, you can read, he would like to stay here, but when they don't talk to him, his mind may be elsewhere.
That is his 20th goal of the season. It's tied up this hockey game. Tyson Berry, long lead pass. Backhanded by Downey. Jackets pick it off. It's Boyce on to Derek Dorsett. Dorsett throws it behind the net. Boyce looking for Gillies. Picked up by Matt Duchesne on the right wing. Duchesne centering feed for Downey. Tipped ahead and into Jackets territory as we close in on the 11-minute mark. A little bit of everything here in this opening period of play. We're tied at one as Mueller plays it in front of the Colorado bench. Dump back. Johnson steps to center. Long shot gloved by Mason. He'll hold on with 8:51 left. We will step aside. Tied at one. Atkinson on a breakaway. Jackets with the early lead. And then McGinn to Jones. Respective coaches behind the two benches, Sacco and Richards, and as we mentioned, going to break. First period had a little bit of everything, Bill.
Boy, did they ever to start it off. You had Dorsett and McLeod, and then Landeskog, he came in. He gave Mason a little bit of a shot. The Jackets take exception. There after the fact, see again, Derek Broussard. And then the goal, the first goal, 6:35, period number one. And then how about that pass from McGinn backside to David Jones? They tied it at one.
Jack Johnson edges it behind the net. Wisniewski reaching for it, unable to play it. Landeskog tied up by the Jackets defender. Broussard edges it back behind the net. Jack Johnson will pick it up. Jackets lift it up, but not out. O'Reilly gets the glove on it. O'Reilly, high slot, fires, gloved and held by Mason. 8:29 left. Let's check out tonight's Toyota Keys, brought to you by your Central Ohio Toyota dealers.
Well, no early avalanche. The tempo must be dictated by the Columbus Blue Jackets. They have done that. Colorado had 5 days off, and you knew they were coming in here for business. Hard up the mountain. Easy making plays up ice in the offensive zone. But you better get back. The transition of Colorado is quick. And then carry on the confidence, all aspects of the game right now. It starts with a mindset, a positive mindset. Compete with that confidence for 60.
Derek Dorsett tied up by Berry. Puck kick free. Play to the point. Prout fires, and that's deflected. Went off the stick of O'Brien and wide. Avalanche attempt to move out of the zone. Here's McGinn returning after a slight back injury. Was a decision made by Coach Sacco and McGinn prior to tonight's game. Former San Jose Shark, acquired just prior to the deadline. 7:48 remaining. We step aside. Teams tied at one. ask Jack Johnson, and he is the subject of tonight's Romeo's Pizza, Who's Hot?
Well, you look at the numbers and look at the ice time, but you know what? Playing in his 81st game this year, he has been a bull on the ice. Hits, block shots, his offensive numbers, they speak for themselves. Right now, probably the most complete defenseman we've had a chance to see in a long time in a Blue Jacket uniform.
Averaging better than 30 minutes per game. You saw on the bottom of that graphic. And he has the franchise record, better than 32 minutes played against the Red Wings. Jack Johnson thriving on that additional work and thriving on the fact that he's quite pleased his season will not end come Saturday. He has accepted an invitation to join Team USA for the upcoming World Championships in Finland and likely will be named the captain. Captain of the squad previously. And when contacted by Brian Burke, immediately said, thank you, I'll be there.
He loves to play the game. You just love that about number seven. You can just tell it the way he walks around the locker room with his gear on as well as with his suit on. Loves to be a Blue Jacket.
Wisniewski. Head up. Dishes cross ice to Jack Johnson. Puck sails deep into the zone. Cleared around the boards. Atkinson will cut it off. Cam Atkinson already made aware that if Springfield, the Jackets farm club, does not qualify for the playoffs, he too has an invite to training camp for Team USA.
Well, the Vantage and Deductible from Nationwide Insurance, you could save $100 off your deductible for every year of safe driving. To learn more, visit nationwide.com or call 877 on your side to find a local Nationwide agent near you. Nationwide is on your side.
Incidentally, John Moore, who continues to sit out due to a foot injury, although he did skate here this morning in the pregame skate. John Moore also has an invitation to join Team USA for the upcoming World Championships. And again, he'll have a chance to at least head to camp and perhaps find himself a spot on the team should Springfield not qualify for the postseason. O'Byrne on to O'Reilly. Out to center and edged off into the corner. Laid behind the net by Brett Lepta. Bouncing puck, stepping up is Jan Hede, able to knock it free. Chips to the corner, but Nikitin there defending. Nikitin turns away from a couple of the Avalanche and dishes for Lepta. 6:10 left. RJ Umberger saw that goal streak snap. Still 5 goals in the last 4 games for RJ Umberger, 8 in the last 7. Derek Brassard looks to the front of the net. Puck picked up here on the left wing. Bull edges off. McLeod gets back up. But the Jackets will move into the offensive zone. And here's Gilly. O'Brien and McClement double team. Centering pass. Nice play there by Bull to toss it in front. But Varlamov able to make the stop and holds on. 5:34 left.
At one inside the Pepsi Center here, Blue Jackets versus the Avs. And Brad, emotional game. No surprise that that's what you're going to see. Blue Jackets show they can play well in emotional games. How can they continue to feed off of it the rest of the game?
Well, obviously, you know, you got guys like McLeod and Downey and the other team that are doing a big push. This is a must game for them. And obviously for us, we've been playing well lately. We've been pushing teams back. And like I said, this first period is going to be a very pivotal period for us on this road trip. So got to come out with a lead here.
Thanks, Brad.
Thanks.
Time of the game. Role players have to step up. You have the Dorsets, you have the Bulls. They've got their pair as well.
How about the Jackets in the faceoff circle? With that last win, they have won 11 of the first 14 draws. Oliver off his skate, chipped ahead by Barry. Landeskog in pursuit. Jackets defend and send it out of the zone. Puck crossing that goal line, touched up by Shane O'Brien. An icing call. And they will head back into Columbus territory. Well, just a reminder, as you enjoy a cold one, to look forward to Miller Time later in tonight's contest. And it's brought to you by Miller Lite.
Well, the Jackets have done a nice job in that faceoff department, Jeff. And since the trade deadline, the Jackets lose all 4 of their centermen. And I really thought at that time we may see a little decrease. And that has not been the case. In fact, if anything, the Jackets have done a better job overall with all 4 centermen.
Backhanded up the right wing. Oliver reaching for it, can't play. Landeskog gets it to him, and it's backhanded in. Avalanche change up. Less than 5 minutes remaining in this opening period. Jack Johnson looks to the right wing for Nash. Nash redirects it quickly into Colorado territory. Jan Heda, who is right now logging more ice time than any other members of the Avalanche here in the opening period, trying to dump in. Jan Heda up on the wing. Crossbow for Nash. Nash waits for reinforcements. Pulls up. Fans on the attempted shot. Heda defending. Sent to center. Nash knocked down by Jones. And the Jackets looking for that lead pass to Letestu. Fails. And it's Heda dishing cross ice. O'Byrne. Stastny into the slot for McGinn. Jackets defend. Stastny wins the battle along the board. Ryan Russell hands it back to Stastny. Throw to the point. Hunwick on to Johnson. Jackets block that. McGinn shovels it behind the net. Downey. Try to make the play. Looks. Centers to McGinn off the shoulder of Mason, who anticipated that play and moved laterally to make the stop. Left wing Downey. Here comes Heydu. Gloved and held by the Jackets netminder.
The 2013 NHL All-Star Weekend is coming to Columbus on January the 26th and 27th. Guarantee your access to tickets for the NHL All-Star Weekend with the purchase of the Blue Jackets Quarter Season Flex Plan for the 2012-2013 season. Flex plans, they start at less than $15 per game. Pick the games you want, save money, and guarantee your place in All-Star history. Call 1-800-NHL-CLS or visit bluejackets.com today.
Here's Derek Brassard. Through and across the line. Brassard looks, a centering feed. Left wing for R.J. Umberger fails. Matt Duchesne now moving up. Duchesne puts the brakes on. Looks into that high slot area. Jackets defend, and it's moved up but not out. Prout will play it off the wall. Pressure coming from Heydu. Able to send it into Colorado territory. Back defending, and it's Berry who sends to center. The puck rolls into Jackets territory. Wisniewski head up, less than 3 minutes remaining. Jack Johnson out of the zone. On here to Prospel. Away from Heda. Dump deep and played by O'Byrne. One-time Montreal Canadian defender. Oliver losing an edge. And the puck shot by Letestu in front. Nash, he shoots and scores. Varlamov thought he had it. The puck squirted free, and Nash bangs it home, closing in on 30 on the year with goal number 28. Jackets regain the lead at 2-1.
Well, it all starts out with Prospel being able to get the puck behind the defense, and then the Jackets put on a little bit of push. You can see the work down below the goal line. O'Byrne turns the puck over. Oliver, he tries to make something happen, but watch Rick Nash and his ability not only to come up with the puck, but then to finish it off as the goaltender Varlamov loses control of it, and Rick Nash finds the back of the net. Nice job by 61.
Ninth point in his last seven games. He had that five-game point scoring streak snapped in the shutout victory by the Coyotes in Phoenix on Tuesday. Little more than 2 minutes remaining. Jackets with goals from Atkinson and Nash. Lead 2-1. As Johnson sends it in deep. Landeskog at the right wing looking for O'Reilly. Landeskog, 21 goals in the season for the rookie. Shot from the point. It's blocked. Boyce able to tip it free. One man back. That's Hunwick. Puck a little high. Hunwick held in check. And play is called.
Well, right now on FoxSportsOhio.com, we've got all of the coverage of opening day from both Cincinnati and Cleveland. Sam Amico asks if the NBA has found a new model franchise. Get it all on FoxSportsOhio.com, presented by 1-800-SAFE-AUTO and SAFEAUTO.com.
Berry paired with O'Brien. Camp behind the net, steps in front, sends it ahead. Jackets able to redirect it back into Colorado territory, albeit briefly. Brassard along the wall. Can't make the play, and here's McGinn. McGinn, high off the glass. Nikit pressure. Centering feed off the side of the net. Stastny denied. Saved by Mason. Lebda out to center. Through and across the line on that right wing. Feathers a backhand pass. Brassard was tied up. Played by McGinn. up and out. Lebda. As the Avalanche change on the fly, Nikitin steps in and across the line and sends a high, hard one just wide of the net. Wisniewski back in his own blue line. Jackets send fresh legs over the wall. Less than a minute to go, and it's Nash drilling it in. Letestu, who picked up the first assist, it was his initial shot that got away from the Colorado netminder. Prospel draws the second assist as Letestu's shot this time blocked by O'Brien. Down he defends. Nash cycling up high, dishes onto Letestu. Off a stick and back out to center. Well into the final minute. Jack Johnson backpedaling into his own zone away from Hajduk. Dishes to Wisniewski. Wisniewski from center. Rifles it in. Far side of the ice. Down he waits for it. Takes a wicked bounce off the dasher. It'll be played here by Jan Hayda. 20 seconds left. Hayda out. Matched up whenever Nash is on the ice. The former Jacket defenseman matched up throughout much of this opening period against the Columbus captain. Eric Johnson. Puck set to center. Here, Hunwick. Hunwick will dish in. Out comes Mason. Final seconds tick off. Jack Johnson, Mueller all over him, and there's the horn to end the opening period. Jack is outshot 11-10, but not outscored. Rick Nash with a go-ahead goal, his 28th of the season, and Columbus skate off the ice with the 2-1 lead over Colorado after 20 minutes of play. Natalie will be joined by a guest when we rejoin you here in the Mile High City of Denver right after this. Getting set for second period play back here in Denver at the Pepsi Center. Jackets lead 2-1. Rick Nash with the go-ahead goal, number 28 on the year. And he, Letestu, and Prospel will start period two up front. Jack Johnson, Wisniewski paired on the point. Stastny set for the draw and wins it cleanly from Letestu. Second period underway here in Denver. Mason wins it high off the glass. Puck sails deep into Colorado territory, touched up, and it's icing. Columbus Blue Jackets hockey on Fox Sports Ohio, brought to you by Penn Station. Penn Station East Coast subs get the grill thing, Penn Station style. By Ohio Health, the official healthcare provider of our Columbus Blue Jackets. Ohio Health, believe in we. And by AT&T, find out what's possible with products and services from AT&T. Rethink possible. Play just underway. And a long clearing pass for Jones. Sails deep. Mason rims it around the wall. Shot from the left wing boards. Mason back in position. The Jackets walk it out to the line. Letestu. Backhands deep. Varlamov gets back into the net as Eric Johnson takes the pass and looks to center ice. Scooped up here on the right wing. O'Reilly, the shot fought off by Mason. Goes off the netting. No further play. Well, let's check out tonight's IGS Energy performers through the opening period of the play. Bill?
How about Cam Atkinson? We talked about his point streak right now and just playing some solid hockey, finding the net. Davey Jones, again, he has always been a thorn in the Jackets' back. And then Rick Nash, goal number 28, as you mentioned, Jeff. But again, another guy putting up some solid points here later in the year.
O'Byrne, Hayda, shot is blocked. Loose puck. Jackets walk it behind their own net. Nikitin, the clearing pass up on that left wing, fails to get anywhere. Nikitin will try again. Turned around on the play. Oliver with an arm on him. O'Reilly carries in. Offside the call. 1:19 into the second.
Well, congratulations to Marcia Krantz and Thomas Hadley. They're two winners of tonight's season ticket holder sweepstakes. Prizes for $250 in fan bucks to use at Blue Jacket home games. Tomorrow's sweepstakes prize is for 50 winners to receive four free tickets to the 2013 NHL All-Star Fanfare. Renew your seats now at BlueJackets.com.
Barry. Here's Duchesne, gloved and held by Mason.
Well, Mason makes the big save off of the 21-year-old. Shane coming back and, well, finally of health. Missed 24 games this year, 20 games with a concussion-like symptoms. But I'll tell you what, when he is playing his game, he is simply outstanding. 2 years in Brampton, number one pick for this hockey team, and came in as a youngster and put up some solid numbers.
Our shot sails wide, knocked up high but not out. Oh, Ryan, centering feed. Jackets walk it out of the zone. Pass for Johansson. Sails into the right wing corner. Dorsett from a sharp angle. Deflected off the stick of the defender. Avoiding a hit here along the near boards was Berry. And it's played Downey. On to Duchesne. Crisscrossing. Duchesne dumps in. Mason out of the net. Mason brings it around the dasher. Dorsett unable to cradle that puck. Johansson stepping into Hunwick. Pass on the right side for Downey. Downey top of the circle. Lets it go. Nice glove save by Mason, and he'll hold on. First appearance for Mason in five games. And trying to make the best of it here tonight.
Chatted with him this morning and said he felt pretty good. And, being out of the lineup and taking the shot in the head by Colton Gillies in warm-up, and the games that he's missed, he's worked hard to get himself back again. Alan York certainly filled the role, and now Mace comes back. It's an opportunity to win a game on the road. Last time in here at the 2-0 shutout at the beginning of March.
Stopped 33 shots that night. Solid performance. Boyce upends Johnson. And it'll be two or four. Boyce lobbying here as he's ushered to the penalty box.
Well, I'll tell you, I see the blade of the stick, and it was more towards the shoulder. This will be a better view once off the stick and then right up off the arm, and probably grazed the chin of Eric Johnson, who went down in a heap. So Boyce goes to the penalty box, only a minor penalty.
The call is high sticking in the Avalanche. On the power play, tied for 11th coming in here tonight. They're now putting up four. I think they're going to add an extra to their bill.
Well, that's
Johnson came back and saw the official here.
Yeah.
It's showing 4 minutes up on that board now, and an explanation from Mike Lego to Todd Richards, the double minor.
Well, there it is. You can see it. Just a slow bleeder, maybe. Well, you look at Todd Richards not very happy. The initial call being made, that means he's got to go back to the bench. If you're an injured player, you must return. You'll have to sit out a shift.
Well, it's not that. It's the fact that he's cut. There's blood. You're not allowed to be on the ice if there's blood. Oh, there it is. A backhand pass and a goal. Stastny able to redirect the rebound in front. Power play goal. And Colorado tied it up.
Well, Stastny has been played very well in the last eight games. That is his fourth goal, and you watch the play. Again, Colorado, they take the puck to the net, and you just hope that if you have an overload down in front of the net, and that's exactly Stastny in the slot area. You have O'Reilly on the backside, and the shot being taken, it eludes the goaltender Mason, who a little slow reacting, coming from his right to left, and Stastny finds the back of the net to tie it at two.
So, just seconds after a total of eight, the initial penalty in the double minor, by the Avalanche have tied it up. Tyson Berry picks up an assist. That's his first point in the National Hockey League. Stastny from Wheeler and Berry. Puck thrown back to the point.
Ready.
Here's Berry. Pressured. Puck sent out of the zone, then backhanded the rest of the way by Letestu. Fresh legs come on for the Avalanche. Similarly, the Jackets making some changes here. On the penalty kill, Johnson walks in. Oh, nice stop there off the stick of Jones, who got behind the Jackets defense, but Mason was there.
2-on-0, Jeff, I'll tell you. Hang on to that save as this game continues, because that's highway robbery by number one, Steve Mason, who then showed great quickness. Again, you see Johnson, a little backhand, and good anticipation by Mason. Again, moving from his right to left. And then the shot by Jones, trying to take it up over top of the pad, unable to do so, and a better save by the goaltender Mason.
Eric Johnson. Back pedals into his own zone. Boyce sitting out the final 45 of that double minor for high sticking. Johnson hands the puck to Duchesne. Duchesne back for Johnson. Up on the right wing. Jones tries to bull his way through. Johnson looks cross ice. Centering feed. Jones denied. Point blank stop there by Mason. Up high. This is Duchesne. Duchesne. Shot sent back to the point. McGinn for Johnson. And he drilled it wide. Downey to the point. Johnson. Duchesne. Glove stop Mason. And he holds on.
I'll tell you what, that's what you want from your goaltender. They score right away on that first of two power plays on that minor penalty to Darryl Boyce. And here you get a chance to watch Mason. Again, good active movement with that blocker side. Right now you see the confidence of the Colorado Avalanche coming to the forefront. They were two of their last 15 on the power play. They're one for one, working on their second.
Stastny's 21st of the season. As you check out Colorado, the first seven shots here of this second period. O'Brien with a pass. That fails. Boyce out of the penalty box, moves up ice. Three on one. Broussard back for Boyce. Oh, he tried to go forehand to backhand. And the Jackets have drawn a penalty here. So the Avalanche will be a man short. And the Blue Jackets will get their first power play, but Boyce on a three-on-one.
Well, he pulls it towards the backhand, and you can see the hook by Stastny to take it inside of Darryl Boyce as he tries to be able to make his move. And, certainly a minor penalty will be called, and the Jackets will have their first power play. Right now, the Avalanche are one for two. The Jackets, their first of the night.
Jackets 27th in power play efficiency at 14.8%. Tied for 11th with a penalty kill are these Avalanche. Hooking minor to Stastny. A 2-2 tie. Nikitin steps to center. Puck rifled in. Gets by Varlamov. Up high, Letestu can't keep it in. Nikitin backing him up. Makes the play at the line. Right wing feed for Dorsett. Pressure coming from Hayden. Letestu hit from behind. And that draws a penalty. Dorsett takes exception to that hit. Now the Jackets are going to get a two-man advantage. Dorsett's got to be smart here. And very calmly skates away and makes sure Letestu's all right. Jackets will have a 5-on-3 here.
Well, let's take a look after the fact. You can see the hit. Again, Letestu back to him. And the minor penalty. And then watch after the fact when Dorsett comes in. He makes sure that things are going to be taken care of. He took a couple of sticks. Good discipline there by Derek Dorsett. As O'Byrne makes his way to the penalty box, and the Jackets will have 1:29 of 5-on-3.
Penalty coming at 5:22. Jackets will have minute 29. A two-man advantage here. Puck thrown to the point. Jack Johnson up high, reversing with Wisniewski, drive block right back to Wisniewski. Waiting, Broussard can't handle that pass. O'Brien off the wall, right back to Wisniewski. James Wisniewski now, winds up, deals, pad save, in front, tipped wide by R.J. Umberger as he was falling, and the Avalanche are clear.
Well, the right idea. Wisniewski gets an opportunity, then on the second chance, he lays it into space to Johnson, and that puck went right through Varlamov.
Here comes Jack Johnson. The C spread moves in deep. Johnson looks cross ice for Nash. Wrist shot high over top of the net. Broussard up on that half wall. Back to Wisniewski. Jack Johnson, one-timer Wisniewski. Right-handed shot on the left point. Shot was blocked in front. Right back to Wisniewski again. On to Broussard. Hangs on, shows patience. Back to Wisniewski. Jack Johnson with it. Umberger. Kemp right on the doorstep. Nash up high. One-timer Wisniewski on the back door. O'Brien down after blocking that shot. Wisniewski gets it back. O'Brien on one leg. Here's Broussard back to Wisniewski. Jack Johnson, Wisniewski fires, stopped by Varlamov. 9 seconds left in the Stastny penalty. In front, Broussard, Nash, he scores! Derek Broussard with a perfect feed. Nash has got his second of the night. The go-ahead goal in the power play. And the Jackets have regained the lead. And how about that pass from Broussard to Nash for goal number 29?
Just great puck movement. Again, when you've got the 5-on-3, that is exactly what it's all about. They try to take away the shooting lanes. But again, Jack Johnson backside to Broussard. And then Rick Nash was ready. He had it ready to go. and Ben one-timer beat Varlamov quickly. The Jackets have taken that 3-2 lead.
One away from number 30.
Caucus goal scored by number
Rick Nash.
Rick Nash assisted by number 16.
And the Jackets remain on the power play as the Stastny penalty still in progress when Nash was able to pull the trigger. So now the Jackets down to 16 seconds on the second of the two penalties. O'Reilly lifts it high and out. Broussard, the first assist. Jack Johnson, the second. Power play goal at 6:47, and it's called on the offside.
Well, there's a look at Joe Sacco. He says, you know what? I look at my young team, and I just think it's great. Here we are, game 81. Our young group still has a lot of meaning in their game. We know exactly what's at stake in this hockey game tonight, but who knows? We have to take care of our own business. Columbus is playing some good hockey. Right now, it's 60 minutes in our own building.
Third time tonight, the Jackets have the lead. Avalanche, centering feed, moving in. Eric Johnson pulling the trigger, but it's sent wide of the net. Goes off the netting, and we will side. 12:26 left, second period, 3-2. The score here at the Pepsi Center in Denver.
Henwick on the left, and how about Matt, his brother on the right? In 4 years, their difference. Matt being the oldest, but again, they get a chance to be in the same building in an NHL rink. Sterling Heights, Michigan, both products of the University of Michigan and Red Berenson. Dad was able to make it in tonight. Mom could not make it, Jeff. She had to work.
Somebody's got to be a breadwinner in that family.
I think Matt's doing a pretty good job.
Quite a thrill, certainly for the Hunwick family. Puck sent up high. There's a shot by Eric Johnson. It's deflected wide. Wisniewski hands to Lechester. Right wing feed. Jack Johnson walks it out of the zone. Sends it high and deep. Lechester gets there quickly. Hunwick dishes for Johnson. Avalanche in off the wing. There's a shot that's blocked off the stick of Jones. McGinn cruising in front. Unable to play it. Jackets have got it. And quickly send ahead here to Vinny Prospel. Prospel will dump off into the opposite corner, then race off to the bench. Climbing over the wall. Jackets get fresh players on here with 11:35 left. Johnson steps to center. Johnson edges it off into the corner, goes right after it. Bumped there by Broussard, fights off the check. Prout sends it up but not out. Prout will try again, reversing. Brings it around the wall, will burn, will play it. Shot high by Downey. Aaron Johnson, the clearing attempt. Picked up here by R.J. Umberger. 2-on-1 with Broussard. Umberger comes in off the wing, fires the shot. Varlamov will hold on as he is outside that goal crease area and gets the faceoff.
Well, Jan Hayda has joined the rush so many times with that Avalanche team that the Jackets take advantage and come back on the 2-on-1 play. A nice job defensively by O'Byrne to take away the passing lane. So what does R.J. Umberger do? Head up, looks to see what he has, and a better save by the goaltender.
Faceoff will come to the left of the Colorado net. Draw one cleanly by the Jackets. Long shot turned aside by Varlamov. Far side of the ice, pressure coming. Ryan Johansson right there along with Derek Dorsett. Dorsett back for Johansson, cut off by McClement. McClement looks up the left wing wall in front of the benches, edged ahead. Mueller in pursuit. He'll get there slightly ahead of Ryan Russell's head came off the puck. Lebda clearing pass picked up by Johansson, scooting down the left side. Right here by Russell. Russell in for Johansson. Mueller defending. Dorsett able to fish it free. McClement up on that left wing. Sends it cross ice. Stepping up O'Brien onto Mueller. Drop pass McClement and fought off a blistering shot that had Mason Ducking got the glove up for protection and held it on.
Well, it was in the midst of a line change and Ryan Johansson got off the ice. They make transition back the other way and his help coming off the bench a little slow trying to get into that open ice. And a good opportunity to be called by Colorado on the quick change and their transition. Mason, a big save.
Look at Landeskog, able to fish that puck free, but committed a little bit too deep. Could not get a shot away. Jackets clear, and it's Gillies in a foot race here. He'll win it cleanly. Holton Gillies. Tried to feed Boyce. Moved up the left wing, stepping up is Wisniewski. O'Reilly is there. Oliver can't make the play, but on the second effort, able to edge a backhand ahead here for Landeskog. Landeskog, a wrist shot. Mason out, traps it behind the net, and left for Jared Bull. Away from Oliver. Boyce out to center. Hunwick, Johnson. Eric Johnson feathers a pass ahead to O'Reilly. Chipped off the glass. Oliver. Held in check there by Boyce. The two battle as the puck squirts free. Going to the point. Berry, long shot. Mason right there with traffic in front. And he'll hold on. 9:18 left. 3-2. Jackets, the go-ahead goal from Rick Nash, his second of the night, 29th of the season.
Lead here inside the Pepsi Center. I am joined by Dan Hino. So far, the Jackets have led this game three times here in the second period. What is the key in preventing the Avs from getting a game-tying goal?
Well, you know what? We got to be defensive-minded. You know, I think we got some old grizzled vets back on the back end with some pretty savvy knowledge of how to do that. And I think in the end, if you maintain your house, keep pucks to the outside, and try and play in their end as much as you can, it's going to give us the edge, obviously, on the defensive end.
Thank you for doing this.
Thank you.
She talks about his own zone. The key number two tonight was the transition, being able to be responsible, coming back and helping out.
Jackets just dodged a bullet there with a giveaway in their zone. They were able to block the shot and prevent a scoring chance. Down the right side, here comes Stastny. His goal, the only goal here for Colorado in the second period. Teams have traded goals. Jackets led 2-1 after one. Stastny tied it up with a power play goal. The Jackets come back with one of their own from Rick Nash, his second of the night. 8:40 left. Colorado with a 10-4 shot advantage here in the second period. Lead 21-15 overall. Berry looks for Stastny. Jackets break it up. Nash chops it to the right wing. Lebda will step up. Berry defended. Lebda edges it off the boards. O'Brien back to scoop up the loose puck. Jackets change up as the Avalanche move up ice. O'Brien had it roll off his stick. Puck gobbled up here by Atkinson. Walks to the front of the net. He shoots and scores. His second of the night. What a great individual effort there by young Cam Atkinson.
Well, a turnover by the Colorado defense. And boy, I'll tell you what, the wrong guy to give it up to is Cam Atkinson. He has the quick hands, but what he's got going to the net is the quick move. And watch number 13 as Umberger lays it into space for him. Watch the move coming out of the corner, face of the goal line, right back up, and it deflects off of the stick and over top of the goaltender, Varlamov. But number 13 did all the work to get there, and they make it a 4-2 game.
Atkinson, second of the night, fourth of the season. Two for Cam Atkinson, two for Rick Nash, and the Jackets have doubled up here on the Avalanche with now 8 minutes remaining here in period number two. Derek Brassard on for Atkinson. R.J. Umberger in the corner. Hayda able to get that puck free. Trout unable to keep it in. Downey on the wing. Centering feed. Jackets knocked that down. Atkinson, good work along the wall. Atkinson dumped to the open corner. Umberger in pursuit. And play called as the Jackets have stormed to a two-goal lead.
Well, this week, Fox Saturday Baseball returns as Matt Holliday and the defending World Series champion Cardinals head to Milwaukee to take on reigning NLB MVP Ryan Braun and the Brewers. Fox Saturday Baseball, it returns this week at 3:30 p.m. Eastern, beginning with our all-new pregame show that covers all the big stories. Get you ready for the first pick on Fox.
Here in front, the puck played along the boards and scooped up by McClement. McClement up on that left wing. Ryan Russell on to Jack Johnson, played by Mueller. Mueller centers the feed. It's off his skate. Jackets up along that far board. McLeod tying up the Jacket winger as the Avalanche find Mueller. Cross ice, stepping up. Through and across the line, Hunwick fires. Stick save, Mason. Played by Mueller. Mueller throws it in front. Jackets defend. That was Jack Johnson getting a stick on it there. Far side of the ice, McClummett. Jack Johnson there. Here's Mueller. Mueller in front. Right across the goal mouth. Mason knocked down. As Wisniewski was thrown right into his own netminder by the oncoming Colorado forward. Mason back up. Appears to be all right. Shot blocked. Jackets up high. Dorsett. He'll chip it off the wall and into Colorado territory. 6:13 left. Jackets with wholesale changes. Carried in offside the call. Well, let's get one more look at the goal. Cam Atkinson, we certainly thought scored it, but the official scorer has given the goal to Brassard.
Well, let's take a look. And again, that puck, as he started to come out, went off of the stick of the defenseman. And when it did, well, Atkinson was the closest to it. He was the last guy to have it.
Does Brassard touch it? No, not at all. No. Off the goalpost.
But O'Brien was the guy. The stick went off, or the puck went off of his stick and into the back of the net.
That'll be changed. We certainly saw it as Atkinson's goal. Indeed, it was. Brassard attempted to get a stick on it, but went glanced right off the goalpost. And it is, in fact, Atkinson's all the way. Although at this point, they've credited the goal to Brassard. Alvin behind the net. Keeps the feet moving. Puck squirts free. It's played there by Jared Bull. 5:35 left. Baby. Puck comes free. At the point. Fought off there with a blocker pad saved by Mason. O'Reilly. Up along the far wall. Boyce there defending. Nick Keaton with an attempt to clear. Can't. Landeskog behind the net. Nikitin gets an arm on him. Landeskog gets free. Throws it back. Nikitin had a stick on it briefly. Up along the wall. A shot by O'Reilly deflected. And with 5 minutes left, we get a stoppage in play. And we will step aside. Atkinson.
Well, there's a younger Tyson Berry. People in Ohio certainly know his dad, Lenny. Wore number 9 for the old Cincinnati Cyclones way back when in the 90s. He lived in Cincinnati until he was 3 years old, born in Victoria, but he certainly charted his own path. Playing for Cologne in the Western Hockey League, he was the Defensive Player of the Year, CHL All-Star, represented Canada in the World Juniors, and boy, does he ever look like his old man.
Got the same mannerisms as well.
Quite a player. He is going to be a good player in this league, Jeff. Not very big, but certainly possessed just like his dad did. Good offensive punch.
Well, his dad had great hands, but fortunately for Tyson, he's a much better skater.
And Lenny, I hope you're listening.
The puck sent to center. Less than 5 minutes remaining. As Wisniewski finds Jack Johnson off the stick of Nash. Puck sails deep into the zone. Hunwick. Enter Eric Johnson. Stastny circles the net. Less than 4.5 left here in the second period as McGinn steps up. On to Stastny. Stastny chipped it wide of the net. Laid in the corner. Steal by Letestu. On to Wisniewski. Clearing pass. Cam Atkinson. Who's got a pair tonight? Atkinson moves in, fires a shot. Varlamov the save, rebound following up, and the puck sails high. It's played. Downey with a clearing pass here for Duchesne. He's got Hayduke with him. Duchesne along that right wing. Aaron Johnson defending. Will sweep it up, but not out. Downey tosses it right back to Duchesne. Duchesne in a battle along the wall. Comes free to Downey. He'll throw it back. O'Byrne. O'Byrne a wrist shot through a crowd. Ricochets off to the far side. Trout wins the battle away from Hayduke. Jackets chip ahead. Aaron Johnson out to center. Long shot. Off the mark. Peta tying up R.J. Umberger. Brassard able to fish that puck free. Dorsett on the wing. Stopped by Hayduke. Downey late in the shift will drop it back. Avalanche into the offensive zone. Duchesne looks for Downey. Downey trying to pull the trigger. Jackets defend and send it back to the Colorado side.
Well, you have Johnson and Prout doing an admirable job of filling in. They only see anywhere between 6 and 7 minutes a night with Johnson and Wisniewski and then Nikitin and Ledda playing together.
battle along the near boards. It comes free and played by O'Brien. Berry. Berry's to center. Chips ahead as he was hit into Jackets territory. Mason out of the net, rims it around the wall. Played Nash. Ahead here, Johansson fires right across the goal mouth. Played along the wall by Landeskog. Gabriel Landeskog headbands that puck here to O'Reilly. O'Reilly across the line, puts the brakes on, away from the key, and slides it off into the corner. Vinny Prosper losing to Oliver. Nash attempting to get a stick on it. Eric Johnson, traffic in front. Stick save, Mason. Back up high, Hunwick. No-look pass picked off, and the Jackets have got a two-on-one if they hustle. There's Prosper. On to Letestu. Nash joins the rush. Letestu looks for Nash. Can't cradle the pass. Behind the net, Prosper had it briefly. But Varlamov able to get a stick on it and will hold on. All rights to this broadcast are reserved, and any rebroadcast, recording, retransmission, or other use of the broadcast without the express written consent of the Columbus Blue Jackets is expressly prohibited.
Well, there's a good look at the Columbus Blue Jacket bench in that last line rush. You got guys like Letestu and guys like Atkinson starting to chip in offensively. Three solid lines right now going, and that fourth line comes in and just adds to the tempo of the hockey game.
R.J. Umberger looking for some open ice. Umberger to the point. Wisniewski the one-timer. Stick to side. Less than 2 minutes left here in the second. Jones down that right wing. Trying to feather a pass. Jackets able to play the puck. Jack Johnson circles the net. Looks up the left wing boards. Umberger fights off the check. Umberger losing his stick, but Atkinson there to help out. Umberger retrieving his hockey stick as Jack Johnson would head up. Centers the pass in the neutral zone. He'll try again. McClement able to chip in, and it sails over the glass and up into the crowd with 1:25 left in the second.
The last play by Jan Hayden, and he's able to chip that puck up, coming in from his defensive position. Cam Atkinson, goals number 3 and 4 tonight. From what we hear, his old alma mater, Boston College, is up 2-0 against Minnesota in the NCAA Finals. Fair State, congratulations to Bob Daniels and staff as they've made it past Union 3-1 earlier on this evening.
Tyson Berry deals. Mueller's shot blocked by Ryan Russell, again sacrificing that body. Jackets move up ice, threw it across the line. Drilled, but fighting it off there. And Derek Dorsett. Dorsett having moves with Eric Johnson. His play continues, less than a minute to go. Here in period number two, long lead pass from McLeod, gobbled up and held by Mason. 5:53.3 seconds remaining here in period number two.
Nikita played game number 100 the other night in Phoenix. And tell you what a surprise this guy has been since that Chris Russell trade from St. Louis. 9 points in the last 9 games from Nikita. I think next year when Tootin gets back from his injury, the hand, and these two guys can get reunited once again, a couple of players that certainly would be go-to guys to match up against the NHL's best once again.
Well, they certainly were pretty effective defensive pairing prior to Tootin breaking his hand, blocking a shot. And I suspect that'll happen again next season as the Jackets hopefully stay a little healthier in the man games lost by this hockey club over the course of the year this season. Never seen anything like it. 6 different goaltenders have been in uniform for the Jackets this season. Of course, the latest to go down today is Alan York. Not expected to start. Mason was going to get the start anyway, but late in practice here, the morning skate, they feared to have suffered a groin injury. That's likely mean for the finale, the Jackets fan appreciation night. Start against the New York Islanders Saturday. We'll likely see Mason back between the pipes. We've played 40 minutes. The Jackets lead by 2. Both Atkinson and Nash with a pair of goals each. Although we're waiting for the correction from the off-ice officials who originally credited the second goal that Atkinson scored to Derek Brassard. We'll be back. Columbus Blue Jackets hockey on Fox Sports Ohio, brought to you by State Farm. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there. By Meijer, higher standards, lower prices. And by your Central Ohio Ford dealers. Ford, drive one. Back here at the arena, the Pepsi Center in Denver. And some news as far as the Western Conference standings are concerned. The Los Angeles Kings have clinched a playoff spot with Dallas losing 2-0 at Nashville. So that means the Blue Jackets have now secured their choice this season or next of that second number one pick acquired in the trade that sees Jack Johnson and the number one pick come over from L.A. for Jeff Carter. Now, that doesn't necessarily mean we know the final seedings, because L.A. can still finish third, seventh, or eighth in the West. They've got a home-and-home series with the San Jose Sharks. And, of course, the Jackets can also eliminate Colorado tonight. And then we simply know the final eight teams from the Western Conference in the playoffs. Of course, the final seedings will be determined in the final games here Friday and Saturday. And for all intents and purposes, the Kings, most importantly the Blue Jackets, the Kings have clinched the playoff spot. And it's now Columbus's choice whether they take that first-round pick in addition to Jack Johnson for Carter, either in Pittsburgh at the June entry draft or wait until the following season.
Well, what can you expect here in period number three, Jeff? Colorado is going to be desperate. They're going to be clawing. Watch the defense. They'll be up on the play all third period.
Of course, Colorado also needs Los Angeles to win the home-and-home series with San Jose and a win here over Columbus. A tall order as the Jackets lead by two in the early moments of this third period. Puck turned over, shot, and the stop by Varlamov as Atkinson looked for his third of the night. Our AEP power play summary. Through 40 minutes of play, both teams 1-for-2. Nashville is 29th on the power play. His sixth power play tally, incidentally. And Stastny has his 21st goal of the season. Stastny among the leaders as well. Stastny with six power play goals prior to tonight. That goal tonight for the extra man was his seventh of the season. Derek Brassard, who, by the way, the goal taken away, the off-ice officials rightfully crediting Cam Atkinson with a second of the night during the intermission. Landeskog down that right wing. Landeskog trying to cut in. Not able to do so. Good defensive play there again by Nikitin. Downing as we approach the 90-second mark. Atkinson with the steal, takes it away from Downing, and the puck fired in.
What a game right now by Atkinson. That last play, yes, he walked out of the corner, had a great opportunity, and then a steal through the neutral zone and got the puck behind the defense.
He's got the two goals tonight, but in addition to that, this is far and away his most impressive game as a Blue Jacket.
And that comes with the confidence, Jeff. 22 years old, just out of college a year ago. Great to see number 13 begin to progress.
And how's his alma mater doing? What's the last score you got
6-1
there?
6-1 right now, Boston College over Minnesota.
Dorsett, good open ice hit there on Alder. Puck played by Hayda. Jan Hayda sends it ahead across the line. Mueller. Mueller, the long wrist shot, gloved by Mason, and he'll hold on.
Well, congratulations to Marsha Grants and Thomas Hadley. They're the two winners of tonight's season ticket holder sweepstake prizes. For $250 in fan bucks, they can use them anytime at Blue Jacket home games. Tomorrow's sweepstake prize is for 50 winners to receive four free tickets to the 2013 NHL All-Star Fanfare. Renew your seats now at BlueJackets.com.
Off the point. O'Brien circles the net. Down as Mason covers up. That's a little bit of a hit to the head from Jones, and he's not too happy about that.
Well, let's watch it right from the puck drop and see exactly what does happen. Again, tonight, the Jackets 58% in that faceoff circle. They lose this one, and then the offense starts from below the goal line. We talked about the defense moving up. That's what O'Brien does. And a little traffic down in front of Mason. Avoids it all. Jackets are able to come out of their own zone.
Bull chips it off the boards. Hustles into the zone. Barry defending. Bull. Gets it to Boyce. Rimmed around the wall. Wisniewski gets it free. Gillies in front. Boyce unable to settle down that bouncing puck. Habs move out of the zone. O'Brien for Stastny. Right back to O'Brien. Unable to play it. Thrown back into the slot. Stastny's shot is blocked. Two Jackets camped in front. Up high, Landeskog. Unwick wrists it wide of the net. McGinn. Stastny able to fish it free, albeit briefly. The Jackets play it. And Atkinson will reverse. Getting word now, the final, Boston College 6, Minnesota 1. They advance to the final against Ferris State. Sets up U.S. College Hockey Final.
Well, good for Ferris State. Never been there before. The staff have some Ohio ties. Bobby Daniels, Mark Kaufman.
Oh, off the mask of Mason and right up into the glove. And again, Mason was hit in practice about a week ago, and he's trying to shake it off here right now. Remember, York, as we get a look at the Ohio Health great save, injured this afternoon.
Yeah, it goes back to period number two. The score at that time was 2-2. And certainly a great save of the game as they go in on a 2-on-0, and Jones on the backside is stymied by Mason.
Jackets back up netminder. Young Hunwick. Up high. Long shot ricochets right to Nikitin. And he's able to clear it out of the zone as he banks it off the board. Look at Dorsett hustle through it. Letestu is there. Chopped away from him. Puck sent ahead. O'Reilly looks. Moving down that right side. Alver pulls up. Fires a shot. Mason, big rebound. O'Reilly throws it back to Hayda. Jan Hayda on for Eric Johnson. Sitting in the right circle. Shot drilled high and wide of the net. And it sails all the way back into Colorado territory.
Well, in the offensive zone, we talked about the defense. Boy, are they part of the rush as well as part of the offense once they set up.
Puck goes off the netting. No further play.
Well, the Columbus Crew, they put up their two-game winning streak on the line this Saturday afternoon at 3 o'clock against the New York Red Bulls, live from Crew Stadium in Columbus. Dwight Burgess, Duncan Otten, they'll bring us all the play-by-play action starting at 3 o'clock on the home of the Crew, Fox Sports Ohio.
Stepping up to center, Jan Hayda tosses it off into the corner. That's McClement. McClement gets some help there from Mueller. Mueller dropped to the ice. Aaron Johnson with a stick on it. Prout finishes his check. Johnson, Aaron able to sweep it to the right wing. Off the skate. Comes up high here to Mueller. Hayda. Full court press here. By these Avalanche, and Mason again able to cover up that loose puck.
Well, right now you have Prout, you have Johnson back on the ice, and Todd Richards as well as assistant coach Brad Berry giving a little confidence to the youngsters, especially Prout. Well, I'll tell you what, he has played pretty well. He's come up at almost 6 minutes the other night, nine shifts. Product out of Sarnia and Berry and Saginaw. He's a big man with certainly a future, whether it's here at the National Hockey League, but he'll develop his skills continually in the AHL in Springfield.
Berry turned around by Russell. McGinn hands it right back to Russell. Russell throws it in front. Wisniewski. Varlamov makes the stop. Up high, Russell able to save it at the line. McGinn, he's got a breakaway. Locks in, denied. Oh, goes crashing into Mason. And Mason appears to be all right. The Jackets take exception. I thought for a moment that Mason was knocked out cold.
Well, the helmet is off. He's certainly dazed, and get a chance and watch the speed of McGinn coming across that line. He has certainly been a find for this team when they trade Daniel Winnick. Watch the big man coming in, lets the shot go, and then right in. Again, situation, does he have time to be able to at least make an attempt to stop? Yeah, he bumped by Jack Johnson. That's a close one. Let's just hope that Mason gets himself up. He makes the better save. The net off, it's Moores.
And you can barely see him, but young Hunwick getting loose.
Well, right now they get Vinny Prospel comes over to talk, and I don't like this right now. When you have a letter on your jersey, you have the right to communicate. And Mike Legel did not like the conversation that was one way coming from Vinny Prospel. Now, whether they give him a 10, does he collect an unsportsmanlike? To be determined.
Well, in the meantime, more importantly, Mason appears to be all right. Mike Vogt had a lengthy conversation with Basin. It was just moments earlier, he took one right off the mask. And then the collision with young Hunwick. What's going through his mind? In the meantime, Lego has called a penalty against Prospel, and it's unsportsmanlike conduct.
Now that's a very poor call in a hockey game where it's 4-2. If it's an individual talking to another official.
Hang on. I think the penalty is being called against Jack Johnson, and perhaps a misconduct has been added to Vinny Prospel. There's a penalty on the board here right now. There's been no announcement made, but number 7, Jack Johnson, is on the scoreboard here right now at one end of the ice with a minor penalty.
Well, what's the minor penalty to Jack Johnson? That's the question mark.
Well, they'll probably call it for interference for knocking McGinn into Mason.
Jack Johnson, 2 minutes for interference.
Indeed, it is. 2 minutes for interference on Jack Johnson. And it is a 10-minute misconduct to Vinny Prospel. So the Avalanche, who are 1-for-2 on the power play, have the extra man here right now. They've got 4 shots on their previous 2 power play attempts. Puck up high. Here's Landeskog now for the goal line. O'Reilly deals to the point for Mueller. O'Reilly back to Mueller. Winds up. Mason's got it. And we'll hold on.
Well, Peter Mueller lets that shot go. And how about the play by Mason being able to come out? He gets himself back. And right now, with Peter back under him, his head is up. A nice job being able to get to the top of the street, top of the crease, as Peter Mueller lets that shot go from the point.
Prospel will be gone for most of this period with the misconduct. Now Jack Johnson down to 1:10 at his interference penalty. Right wing, that's Duchesne. Dishes the play up high. Tyson Berry on here to Downey. Aaron Johnson got a stick on it, lost it, and was able to deflect it wide of the net. Johnson reaching for it, can't make the play. McGinn along the wall, can't keep it in. Jackets pressure Berry. Here's Downey. Dorsett gets a stick on it. Very aggressive here on the kill. Dorsett now will race off to the bench. R.J. Umberger up high. Ryan Russell comes off the bench. Jackets will clear. Aaron Johnson able to send it the length of the ice. Less than 30 left in the Jack Johnson minor. Jackets on the kill. Turned around was Umberger. Wisniewski up high. Long wrist shot ricochets off Umberger and wide of the net. Eric Johnson for Colorado sprints through the neutral zone. Dishes to the left wing for Landeskog. Landeskog unable to cradle that puck. Fights off a check. O'Reilly fires from a sharp angle. Mason looks for it. The puck was deflected up high. Out steps Jack Johnson. He's got a breakaway. Mueller is back. Jack Johnson can't make the play.
No
penalty. As Mueller was all over him. Now, Letestu for Jack Johnson. Stepping up is Atkinson. And Varvalov gets a piece of that one. Landeskog. Atkinson with the steal. What a night. Hands to Letestu. Mark Letestu. Dishes to the point. Here's Prout. Walks the line. Atkinson. Down low. Unable to redirect. The Letestu shot. Comes back up high. One-timer there. Kick save. Mueller will play it. Mueller lifts it high and out. 8 minutes plus gone here in the third period. Jackets dodge a bullet. Outstanding penalty kill on the just completed power play for Colorado.
Well, very aggressive. Starting in their own zone, James Wisniewski did a great job of taking away lanes, a good active stick, and then good pressure in the offensive zone.
Colorado did not register a shot on the just completed manpower advantage. Hunwick. The backhander sails wide, up along the wall, thrown to the point, but not out. Hunwick, with some hustle, able to save it. Aaron Johnson, who is superb on that penalty kill. Jackets look to the right wing. Here is Derek Brassard. Steps to his side of center, and then drills it deep. Ryan Russell, another solid defensive effort. Russell, and Stastny, able to steer that puck free. Dorsett on the wing. A high rising shot sails over top of the net
goes off the netting. 11:04 left. Third period. We'll be back. Jackets lead by two. Jackets lead by a score of 4-2 as we pan the Blue Jackets bench. And you'll recall here prior to the Jackets penalty and the start of the Colorado power play, Vinny Prospel arguing that minor penalty. Lego continues to jaw at him. Prospel just wants an explanation.
And that's it. I mean, he's got a letter in his, on his jersey. He's 37 years old. He's been in the league for 15 years. And then they continue to talk. I love communication, but I thought it was certainly a little excessive. It wasn't like he was in his face. It was communication all along.
Here on the right wing, Ryan Johansson. Played here by Colorado's Hayden. Blue line behind the net, Mason, and it's left for DeKeaton. Puck rifled behind the net. Not only has Vinny Prospel not on the Blue Jackets bench, but I can tell you too now as I pan and look over why Rick Nash, the Jackets captain with a pair of goals tonight, is not on the Columbus bench either. So right now the Jackets are down a couple of forwards, and I'm just being handed this note. No sooner do I say it that Nash has an undisclosed injury and will not return.
Well, that's where, again, you've got to go down the depth of your organization. You look at the guys like Gillies. Bowl should see some ice time. Third line with Derek Dorsett, Russell. They'll come out as well.
4-2. We have passed the midway point of this third period. Eric Johnson. Steps away. Atkinson had a stick on it momentarily. O'Reilly with Landeskog. O'Reilly, the wrist shot blocked by Wisniewski. Another solid performance for James Wisniewski. A +2 tonight. Coming back in his second game after suffering from a concussion. O'Reilly lifts it high off into the corner. Bouncing puck will be played by Wisniewski. O'Reilly pressures. Landeskog is there as well. O'Reilly had it briefly. Broussard winning the battle below the goal line. And here, banked off the boards by Gillies with Bull in pursuit. Jared Bull, Colton Gillies. Gillies tosses to the open corner. It'll be played there by McGinn. Outlet pass knocked down by Bull. Good effort to keep it in up high and toss it behind the net. 8:50 left. The crowd getting a little anxious here as the Avalanche, with a loss here tonight, would be eliminated from the postseason. Played by Stastny. 8:34 left. Off the wall. O'Brien out of the zone. Dorsett had it momentarily. Russell does and tosses it back. Jackets doing a good job of playing keep away here. Darryl Boyce, who set up the first goal of the night with a long stretch pass to put Atkinson in home free. And the Jackets have not looked back since.
No, they really haven't. The defense have done an excellent job. Mason, some timely save, especially in period two.
Eric Johnson stopped Mason. Rebound with a scramble in front. Doing the splits, Mason. And with some help from the defense in front of him, the Jackets are able to clear. Less than 8 left. Downey looking for Duchesne. Jackets break that up. Nikita paired with Prout. Jackets lifted high and out. Boyce on that backhand. Atkinson looks for it. The puck gobbled up and played by Hunwick. Eric Johnson. Camp momentarily behind the Colorado net. 7 minutes, 32 seconds left. Long pass on that right wing. Downey edges it into Jackets territory. Prout walks it to the line. Looks to the right wing there for R.J. Umberger. And offside the call. 7:22 left, third period. Columbus 4. Colorado 2. Back after this. As we promised earlier in the game, it's Miller time, brought to you by Miller Lite.
Well, Rick Nash may be out of the lineup right now, but he certainly made his name in the scoreboard here tonight. A couple of goals. This one back in period number one, 17:29, even strength goal, and then a 5-on-3 goal. Watch the pass by Broussard. Backdoor, the one-timer by 61. He finds the back of the net at that point to make it a 3-2 game.
from the draw. Puck played ahead on that left wing, O'Reilly. Offside to call. Vinny Prospel is sitting out a 10-minute misconduct, but if I was a betting man, I would bet that Prospel will have that misconduct rescinded, and I'll tell you why. Prospel's got an A on his jersey. Rick Nash is not dressed here. He is through for the night, not on the ice for the third period. So, again, you're allowed to have your captain, or in his absence, one of his assistants, at least get an explanation. And Lego refused to give Prospel an explanation. You saw the video earlier. I bet you that misconduct is rescinded.
Well, the letter, the age, who he is, and what it's all about. Jeff, I would agree with you.
Here, the puck sent back and drilled wide of the net. It appeared he basically was asking for an explanation. There wasn't a lot of chatter. It was more body language. Prospel just wanted to know why or how he could call the Jack Johnson penalty for interference. Jack Johnson sends it ahead in that high slot, and it's played there by Wisniewski. R.J. Umberger going it into the slot. 6 minutes, 24 seconds left. Landeskog through and across the line. Landeskog going wide on Wisniewski. It does not give him much real estate to work with.
Well, Landeskog, he was all alone and was able to do his job, getting the puck into that offensive zone, and a nice job by Wisniewski.
Now Wisniewski and Landeskog. Landeskog had that fighting major previously. They're both going to go here right now. Wisniewski. Jack Johnson steps in, and McGinn grabs Wisniewski. Wisniewski's trying to remain cool here. Remember, he just comes back from the situation where he had the concussion.
Yeah, no question. When you have Landeskog coming after him, again, look at where Wisniewski is. He gives him a little shot. And then Landeskog, a cross check. And then they continue. They say, okay, two and two and two. And then, well, he continues to come after him. Landeskog could have skated away, but he wanted to stay involved. And if I know if Joe Sacco, here is one of your leading scorers making his way to the penalty box, and with the 6:02 to go and the season's on the line, boy, some learning.
Well, Landeskog is, just before we get a look at some footage here, I just want to finish one thought here on Landeskog. Landeskog is frustrated here because this young man has impressed pretty well every time we've seen him play in person and certainly on television. The Jackets have done a great job defending against him here tonight, and I think that's frustration more than anything else.
Well, that's where, again, growth has to take place, Jeff. You're 18, 19 years old, and you're vying for a penalty, for a playoff spot. You don't want to be in the penalty box.
Well, here's Rick Nash getting massaged there on the bench. Nash back perhaps tightening up, and maybe a big reason why he is out for the balance of the night.
Well, it looked like on that one time that he had on the 5-on-3, he was kind of out of position. He was loading up for the shot, and it just looked like his body was in an awkward state. But we'll have to find out after the fact. Any way you look at it, the captain on the bench.
We're back in the dressing
room. We're back in the dressing room. Or around.
Nash has appeared in every game this season. And if there's any way possible, I suggest he'll play in the finale come Saturday. Not miss the game. One of a short few that have been able to play every game. Now we have, we've heard this before, but a minor clock malfunction delaying the start.
Do you want to delve into that conversation about the clock in L.A. and everything else, Jeff? I mean, there's a lot happening in the National Hockey League.
Not necessary. That's water under the bridge.
Todd Richards didn't want to talk about it this morning either.
Ancient history. Here's the key. Dishes cross ice. Jack Johnson. Back for the key. Drilled. Varlamov able to stop it. Loose puck played ahead, but not out. Good save at the line there by Ryan Johansson. On to Jack Johnson, who was slashed at. Jack Johnson up high, sends it back to the point. Jackets with Landeskog picking up the additional minor. Jackets on the power play. And in front, Dorsett. Jones, backhands. Jack Johnson not able to play it, and hustling back here is Nikitin. First legs come on for Colorado. A little more than a minute left in the power play. 5:05 left, third period. Jackets 4. Avalanche 2. Nikit settles it down. Looks ahead. Crowd pretty well out of it right now. The Jackets. Atkinson seeing some power play time. There it goes right off the pipe. Atkinson up high. Dishes. In front, Umberger behind the defense. Sends it off the side of the net. Umberger retrieves below the goal line, swept off his stick, hammered off the wall, beyond Jack Johnson, and back into Jackets territory. Less than 30 left.
Well, Jackets very smart. Just move it around the outside. Try not to throw it into the pads. Good puck management by the Jackets.
4:24 left. 20 seconds on the power play because of that malfunction of the clock. We apologize. The Fox box is down. And it's played here by Brett Lebda. Off into the corner. Down to 10 seconds of the power play. A little more than 4 minutes left. 4:07 to be exact. Race for the puck. Lebda. Knocked away from Jones. Jack Johnson to the Colorado line. Penalty's over. Landeskog back on. No further play. 3:55 left. 4-2. Jackets with the lead.
A little look as far as what's going on in this hockey game tonight. How about Cam Atkinson? Well, a good night for Cam. Not only does his alma mater win and move on to Fair against Fair State in the NCAAs, he's got 2 goals, goals number 3 and 4 of the season.
Out comes Varmolov, and the sixth skater comes on. The Avalanche need 2 goals. Scramble in front, down Mason, covering up in the paint, no further play. 3:44 left. The Avalanche have to win this game either in overtime or regulation. They trail by 2. They cannot go to a shootout, but quite a tall order here. Down 2 goals with 3:44 left. They put the goaltender on ice. And we'll go with 6 skaters here in an attempt to remain in the playoff hunt.
I think it's a great move. Watched it before at the collegiate level. 5-0 game in the second period. The coach has done it and come back. They ended up losing the game, but they scored 5 goals, and 3 of them with a goaltender out.
Landeskog. He's a dance 3. Landeskog knocked down by Jack Johnson. O'Reilly up high. Dishes behind the net. Jones will play it off that backboard. Sends it back here to Eric Johnson. The net empty at the far end of the ice. Landeskog in a battle there. Loses it to Jack Johnson. O'Reilly up high. Wrist shot off the shoulder of Mason. The rebound caroms all the way here to the near board. Loose puck played by Landeskog into the corner for Stastny. Jackets defend. Trying to box out this Avalanche Hockey Club. Scramble in front. They jam the front of the Columbus net. Play whistle down. And the faceoff will come to the left of Mason. Timberland play of the game. And we've got a pair of goals from young Cam Atkinson.
Well, go back to 6:35 of period number 1. The Jackets want to get on the board. And what a pass by Darryl Boyce to be able to find Atkinson. He makes the move. And then Atkinson all his own coming out of the corner. Being able to make the move. It hits the stick of O'Brien. Deflects off of Varlamov and into the back of the net. And as we mentioned, he had 29 goals in the American Hockey League in Springfield. He brought up after that trade deadline. He's able to have 4. 2 in this game tonight.
Joe Sacco. Seeing to get his hockey club going here. Down by a pair with exactly 3 minutes remaining.
Once again, the defense will be able to be up. You've got the goaltender out. The one thing that they'll do, they'll have a guy behind the net. They'll have the sides, the hash marks covered along the walls, and then people down in front. The key for this, they've got to be able to get pucks if it does go high through. And if not, they'll deflect. They'll also force the side of the net in hopes of a rebound coming out in front of that high traffic and that high rent area.
From the draw, 6 skaters remain on the ice for Colorado. Jones held in check, able to sweep it behind the net. Eric Johnson. Dishes onto Stastny. Landeskog, cross ice. Umberger had a stick on it to deflect it away from O'Reilly, who had pinched in off the point. Now O'Reilly on that half wall. Back for Stastny. Eric Johnson drills it. Shot blocked. Went off Landeskog. Jackets will play it. The net empty. Atkinson racing into the zone. Stastny will get there first. Jackets call for icing. 2:23 left.
Well, fans see the Blue Jackets take on the New York Islanders on Fan Appreciation Night. That's going to be Saturday, April the 7th, 7 o'clock game with the Dispatch Family Value Pack. It includes a pre-game family skate at the Ohio Health Ice House from 5 to 7. Game ticket, hot dog, Pepsi, UDF ice cream coupon, and more starting at just $25 a person. 50% savings. Get your tickets now at BlueJackets.com.
From the draw, Nikitin high off the glass and out. Avalanche get it back. Downey on that right wing, fire, save Mason, rebound knocked out of the air by Nikitin. The Avalanche will play it, so play would be allowed to continue. Tyson Berry on to Mueller, right back to Berry. Berry away from Dorsett. Avalanche game, the offensive zone. Mason communicating with his defense, over the stick of Berry. Puck rolls deep into Colorado territory, less than two left. Eddie Crossbow on the ice, having served his 10-minute misconduct. Mason high off the glass and out. And this one sails over the glass and up in the crowd. No delay of game penalty as it went off an Avalanche stick and off the glass, off of the crowd.
You know, there's a look at Steve Downey making his way back to the bench. He certainly was a welcome addition. Landeskog. Guy right now, an unofficial polling by Adrian Dater here in the newspaper. He says right now he is the Calder Trophy winner by a poll that he took with other sports writers.
Now it's either him or Nugent Hopkins. We saw Edmonton here recently. We talked about Hopkins and played far number fewer games. That kind of give the edge to Nugent Hopkins, but that'll be determined in Las Vegas at the NHL Awards show in June. Look at Atkinson. The net empty. Atkinson hustles to it. Fires from a sharp angle. Johnson. There's Atkinson with a hat-trick goal. And that will ice it. And the Avalanche will be derailed from any thoughts of a postseason playoff spot. Cam Atkinson with the hat-trick goal. And that was sheer hustle there.
Well, he had a multi-assist game in St. Louis. He had the game-deciding goal in Calgary. And there another second effort, an individual effort, his first NHL hat trick, and two of those goals, he did it all on his own. I'm telling you what, this guy is gonna have a future, and the key with guys that size, can he stay healthy? Yes, number one, but number two, he has the skills, he has the speed, and he has the tenacity to compete.
Daily double for Cam Atkinson, hat trick in his former team, Boston College, qualifying the college final against Ferris State. But really made that play. Well, Eric Johnson was able to defend Atkinson. He never gave up on him. And Atkinson with hustle, able to send it home into the empty net for his third goal of the night. Here, the puck knocked down. Jackets play it. Long lead pass for Ryan Russell sails into the zone. Elon Hayduk.
35.
Hayduk dishes far side. That's O'Byrne. O'Byrne pressured by Gillies. Hangs onto it. Now we'll walk it out of the zone. Less than 30 left. Through and across the line. Puck played. Ahead. Jackets send it over O'Byrne. Marmalade will tee it up. Atkinson. From Mason. Mason draws the assist. That's his second assist of the season. As the puck caroms into the zone. Gloved by Mason. Tossed to the corner. Steve Mason. Back-to-back wins against Colorado here in Denver. A solid performance in goal. Jackets win 5-2. And moments after the goal by Atkinson into the empty net for his hat trick. The linesman retrieving the puck. That's Pierre Rasico. He'll hand it here to Vinny Prospel. Prospel will carry the memento over to the Jackets bench, and Cam Atkinson records the hat trick. Jackets win 5-2, win their fourth in the last five games. and continue their spoilers roll.